Chapter 9, Life Processes in Animals, Question Answer from Grade 7, Subject Science, Book Curiosity. Let us enhance our learning. Question 1, complete the journey of food through the alimentary canal by filling up the boxes with appropriate parts. Answer, first food, then mouth, then oesophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, anus. Question 2, Sahil placed some pieces of chapati in test tube A. Neha placed chewed chapati in test tube B. And Santushti took boiled and mashed potato in test tube C. All of them added a few drops of iodine solution to their test tubes A, B and C respectively. What would be their observations? Give reasons. Answer. Test tube A, plain chapati, turns blue-black, indicates presence of starch. Test tube B, chewed chapati, shows little to no blue-black color because saliva breaks starch into sugar, reducing starch content. Test tube C, boiled mashed potato, turns blue-black, potato contains starch which reacts with iodine. Reason, iodine reacts with starch to give a blue-black color, chewing with saliva reduces starch due to enzymatic activity. Question 3. What is the role of the diaphragm in breathing? Answer. Third, to help in inhalation and exhalation. Explanation. The diaphragm is a dome-shaped muscle that moves down during inhalation and up during exhalation, helping the lungs expand and contract. Question 4. Match the following. Name of the part. Functions. First, nostrils. A. Fresh air from outside enters. Second, nasal passages. D. Tiny hair and mucus help to trap dust and dirt from the air we breathe. Third, windpipe. E. Air reaches our lungs through this part. Fourth, alveoli. B. Exchange of gases occurs. Fifth, ribcage. C. Protects lungs. Question 5. Anil claims to his friend Sanvi that respiration and breathing are the same process. What questions can Sanvi ask him to make him understand that he is not correct? Answer. Sanvi can ask, is breathing the same as using oxygen to produce energy? Does breathing break down glucose? Can we call the act of inhaling and exhaling a chemical process like respiration? Explanation. Breathing is a physical process, air in and out. Respiration is a chemical process, glucose plus oxygen gives energy. Question 6. Which of the following statements is correct and why? Anu, we inhale air. Shanu, we inhale oxygen. Tanu, we inhale air rich in oxygen. Correct statement, Tanu, we inhale air rich in oxygen. Reason? Air is a mixture of gases, mainly nitrogen and oxygen. When we inhale, we take in air rich in oxygen, not just oxygen alone. Question 7. We often sneeze when we inhale a lot of dust-laden air. What can be possible explanations for this? Answer. Sneezing is a protective reflex. When dust enters the nose, tiny hairs and mucus in the nasal passage try to trap it. If the dust irritates the nose lining, it triggers a sneeze to expel the irritants and clear the airways. Question 8. Paridhi and Anusha of grade 7 started running for their morning workout. After they completed their running, they counted their beats per minute. Anusha was breathing faster than Paridhi. Provide at least two possible explanations for why Anusha was breathing faster than Paridhi. Answer. Two possible reasons. First, Anusha may have run faster or exerted more, requiring more oxygen and hence faster breathing. Second, Anusha's fitness level might be lower, so her body needs more effort, oxygen to recover after exercise. Question 9. Yadu conducted an experiment to test his idea. He took two test tubes A and B, this one and this one, and added a pinch of rice flour to the test tubes, half filled with water and stirred them properly. To test tube B, he added a few drops of saliva. He left the two test tubes for 35 to 45 minutes. After that, he added iodine solution into both the test tubes. Experimental results are shown in figure 9.15. What do you think he wants to test? Answer: Yadu was testing the action of saliva on starch. Saliva contains enzymes that break down starch into sugar. After 35 to 45 minutes, iodine added to test tube B with saliva would show less or no blue-black color, indicating starch breakdown. Question 10. Rakshita designed an experiment taking two clean test tubes, A and B, and filled them with lime water as shown in the figure. In test tube A, the surrounding air that we inhale was passed on by sucking air from the pipe, and in test tube B, the exhaled air was blown through the pipe, figure 9.16. This one. What do you think she is trying to investigate? How can she confirm her findings? Answer: She was investigating the presence of carbon dioxide in exhaled air. Test tube A, inhaled air, no change. Test tube B, exhaled air, lime water turns milky, showing CO2 is present. CO2 is carbon dioxide. To confirm her findings, she can repeat the experiment and observe that only exhaled air causes lime water to turn cloudy, providing it has more carbon dioxide than inhaled air. Next, exploratory projects. First, what are the good practices for maintaining oral hygiene? Try to gather information on the same from books, newspapers, conversation with elders. Prepare a report. Answer: Sources, conversations with elders, newspapers and books. Good practices include brushing teeth twice a day, morning and night, using fluoride toothpaste to prevent tooth decay, cleaning the tongue regularly, rinsing the mouth after every meal to remove food particles, using dental floss to clean between teeth, avoiding sugary snacks or drink, especially at night, visiting the dentist for regular checkups every 6 months, traditional practices from elders, using neem twigs for brushing, rinsing mouth with salt water for gum health, chewing clove or cardamom to reduce bad breath. Second, find out different ways to maintain a healthy digestive system. Suggest some food items that help to maintain good digestive health. Make a report and present it in class. Answer: Healthy habits, eating on time and avoiding overeating, chewing food slowly and properly, drinking plenty of water, including fiber-rich foods, fruits, vegetables, whole grains, regular physical activity, walking, yoga, avoiding junk food, oily and spicy meals, helpful food items, curd, buttermilk, contain good bacteria, papaya, banana, aid digestion, ginger, cumin, ajwain, traditional aids for digestion, millets, gluten-free and fiber-rich alternatives. Conclusion: A balanced diet, good habits and awareness ensure a strong digestive system. Question 3. Using colored clay, prepare a 3D model of the digestive system and label all parts of the digestive system using black paper strips. So friends, you have to do this yourself. Materials required: colored clay, red, brown, yellow, green, black paper strips, toothpicks, sticks for labels. Steps: First, use brown clay for the mouth, esophagus and rectum. Second, use red clay for the stomach. Third, use yellow clay for the small intestine, long and coiled. Fourth, use green clay for the large intestine, shorter but wider. Fifth, use paper strips to label mouth, esophagus, stomach, liver, pancreas, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. Objective: Understand the path of food and organs involved in digestion. Fourth, what is air quality and AQI? Find out the effect of air quality on the respiratory systems of people working in various fields, farmers, factory workers, or street vendors. Answer: AQI measures air pollution levels on a scale from 0 to 500. Lower AQI is equals to cleaner air, higher AQI, more polluted. 0 to 50, good. 51 to 100 moderate, 101 to 200 poor, 201 to 300 very poor, 301 to 500 hazardous. Effects on different workers, group farmers, respiratory impact, exposure to crop dust, pesticides, causes coughing, breathing issues. Second, factory workers, respiratory impact, inhale chemical fumes and fine particles, risk of asthma, bronchitis. Next, street vendors, respiratory impact, exposed to vehicle emissions and dust, risk of chronic respiratory problems. Conclusion, high AQI can damage lungs and cause long-term respiratory diseases. Use of masks, awareness and pollution control are necessary. Fifth, try to read about the box breathing technique, figure 9.17, this one. What are its benefits? Answer, a breathing exercise involving equal time for first inhale, example 4 seconds, second hold breath 4 seconds, third exhale 4 seconds, fourth hold again 4 seconds. Benefits, reduces stress and anxiety, improves concentration and focus, helps in emotional control, increases lung capacity and oxygen intake, enhances mental clarity and calmness. Tip, practiced by yoga enthusiasts, athletes and even military personnel. Next, both birds and mammals have lungs for breathing, but birds can fly at high altitudes where oxygen levels are low. How might their respiratory system be adapted to help them survive in such conditions? Answer. Problem. Less oxygen is available at high altitudes. Bird adaptations. Birds have air sacs connected to their lungs. Their lungs allow continuous flow of fresh air even during exhalation. This unidirectional airflow ensures efficient gas exchange. Their blood has a high oxygen carrying capacity. Conclusion. These adaptations allow birds to fly at high altitudes. Example, bar-headed geese fly over the Himalayas without suffocating. So friends, we have completed all the question answers from chapter 9, Life Processes in Animals. We have already studied short notes and summary of this chapter. You can find the link in the description and on the screen. If you like the video, kindly like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel. We will meet in the next video. Thank you for watching.